हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज़ डॉक्टर उमेश कुमार आर्या, फैकल्टी ऑफ मीडिया स्टडीज़, गुरु जम्भेश्वर यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी. इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल वी वुड डिस्कस सम मोर फीचर्स ऑफ द माइंड मैपिंग सॉफ्टवेयर कॉल्ड द माइंडोमो. फर्स्ट वी विल गो टू द माइंडोमो. या एज डिस्कस्ड in the first presentation of Mindomo, we have prepared this mind map of my life sketch, and I have added some of the links here, and research publications and international publications. Then I have mentioned my international publications here. Like, these are my four international publications, and if somebody wants to read those publications, then he just needs to click the link after this, and he or she would be taken to that research publication. Yeah, so this is our research publication, and anybody who has the access to the internet straight away can read the publication. So the question is how to attach these documents files to the mind map. So we will go to the Google Docs. You type this URL docs.google.com, or you can click the link of the document from your Gmail account also. And these are my research publications which I have uploaded from my PC. Now I want to make a link between this publication and the link here. So I want to make the links between these two. So what I will do is I will select this. Okay, I will select this, and I will come to the right side of it, and I will see the sharing part. Setting button is there. I will click that. So, link to share is this. I will copy this link, and I will go to Mindomo presentation, and I will click the hyperlink, and I will add this link here. It is already added because I have already done this. So if you close this, then your link is ready, and the next time when you click this link, then it will straight away open you to the concerned research publications. So this is one of the very good method. So we can attach anything now to these topics. Google doc file is also added. PDF file can also be added like this, and you can insert the photograph also. And how to do it? Suppose I want to insert the photograph in my life sketch, so I would select that first, and then I will go to multimedia, and I will go to the image section. Like, these are some default images, inbuilt images from Mindomo, and these images are grouped under these headings. If I want to add something related to the some photo related to education, then I will click this, and Mindomo gives me lot many images related to the education. It is similar to the image gallery in MS Office, yeah. And I will click, and this image would be inserted in the concern box. So this is one of the very nice ways to do it. You can enlarge it, you can make it small, or whatever you can do it, and then you can close it. So this way our image has been inserted. Now if I want to insert image in this box, and that image should be from the internet, then what we would do is we would go to my pictures and we would type the name of the image here. So yes, okay, sorry, we have to go to public link and then we have to type the image name first. Mindomo will search Flickr, Wikipedia and Google images for these photos. Suppose I type Guru Jambheshwar University and then press enter. So it will and click Google here. Yeah, it will search the Guru Jambheshwar University's photographs from Google Images. So it will gradually displays all the photos related to GJU. Suppose I want to insert this, then I will select this. This will automatically come here and I will click add. So you see that university's logo would be inserted here. It is loading and yeah, it is done. So this is your image insertion from the net. You cannot upload images from your computer because that is a paid facility from the Mindomo. So you can place that photo anywhere on the net and give a link to the field here, and then it would fetch the photograph from that link. But it is always better to place your photo on Facebook, blogger.com or anywhere else, so that Google Images can search your photos and straight away the link can be made from here. So this is done. Closing this would, now see, you can see this red boundary around this international publications subtopic. So what is the function of this boundary? Suppose I click this and I click this this subtopic also. So there is a question, there is a slight chance of getting these two links mixed because these are international publications and these are our national publications. So if color of these two elements are same, so there's high chances that they would be confused. So in order to avoid this confusion, I have created the boundary around this group of elements so that immediately it is recognized as the different group. And how to do it? You have to go to the boundary. First click insert and then go to boundary and select the type of boundary you want to introduce in this. Suppose this is rectangle, then you press this rectangle and see, I had selected this research publication, so it has these two further subtopics. So these topics, they have been grouped, all of them, you see. Yeah, this white line, it is covering this whole link. In order to change the color, just go to format and type, press this boundary color. So yeah, so if your presentation is very complex and it is having so many topics and further top subtopics and the further subtopics, so you can resort to this boundary making, so it will avoid the confusion in that. So this is the area demarcation for our mind mapping presentation. I'm going to minimize it, and yes, this is done. And next is how to insert the music inside this mind mapping presentations. So for that, for example, I want to add some music to this life sketch, so I will click this first. Then go to multimedia. As you know, music is the part of multimedia element, so we'll add audio, and it needs the URL. URL means it says that the song or the music which you want to insert, it should be already present or uploaded somewhere on the net. So for that, this is very good website, divshare.com. You signed up with this, and when you enter your dashboard area, then you come to this page and you press upload a new file. New file means the music file. So when you press this upload, then it will start working and it will ask for a music file from your computer. You choose your file. Choose your music file MP3 and then upload it. So I'm not going to do it because the file has been already uploaded. If I go back, then you see I have uploaded this file, Ek Pyar Ka Nagma Hai. So how to make the link of this file to our element on the MindOpo? So I would click this first and it will have this link share. If you want to download this file, you like this song very much, then you can press this download and this file would be downloaded to your PC. But now we have to share, so we will click this and it will give us a link. This is the link, and we would copy this link and we will go to our MindOmo presentation and we would place that link here. And I will press add. As soon as I press the add, then see my icon is converted into a music file. So I can play the music from here and I will enjoy the song. So like, you can insert n number of music files, n number of videos in this. The main point to be noted here is Mindomo does not import the sound file into its presentation, but it makes a link from this My Life Sketch element to the location of this music file, that is the file hosting service. So this was the regarding the embedding the music file in the Mindomo presentation. So if you insert maximum elements, maximum multimedia elements in your presentation, then your presentation would be looking good for the visitors. And one more thing, instead of saving file on the Word format and making a link, we can save our file somewhere on the internet in the PDF format and make a link of that file to our element here. For example, if somebody wants to see my curriculum vitae, then he will click this link and he will be immediately taken to the PDF file of my curriculum vitae on the net. So in this case, I have uploaded the PDF file of my curriculum vitae on scriptd.com, and when I upload my document on Scriptd, it gives me a link in the same way as given by the div share. It will give me this embed link so that I can embed this song in my blogspot.com or in my on some other personal website, or it can give me the link from here. So Scriptd has hosted my document and it has given me this link. Whosoever visited this link would be presented with my curriculum vitae, and I have copied this link from here and I have pasted it here by clicking this hyperlink. So whosoever clicks this link will be immediately taken to the CV online with the scriptd.com. So friends, you can insert any element in your presentation. You can insert images, you can insert a sound file, you can insert the video from YouTube, you can insert any doc file, you can insert any PDF file, and there is nothing much left after discussing the text, sound, movie, animation, etc. So your multimedia presentation is ready. So it is up to you now how you decide to make your mind mapping presentation in a creative way. And if you open this, presentation, suppose you are making it public, and I will go to the dashboard and my screencast presentation is there, and I will click this, I will share it, I will click the publishing part. Now to URL to view this map HTML page, or URL to view this map, this is the link where I would copy this. It has been copied. I will go to some other open new website and I will press Ctrl V, and then I will open this presentation from here. This is the link which would be generated by Mindomo, so that you can send this link to your friends, and when they will click this link, then Mindomo presentation would be opening before them. So this is the Mindomo presentation. See, it has got all the information, like My life sketch is the file's name. It is prepared by Umesh Arya. And if you see at the bottom of it, then author's name is there, Umesh Arya. Modified 22 hours ago. Viewed 21. It means 21 visitors. They have seen it, and nobody has voted it till now. Yeah, if you see here, then you will see 1, 2, 3. Now, what are these 1, 2, 3? Keep your central idea clicked. Keep your mouse on this and just click once. And then, if you click all, then you see all the links and the sublinks would open immediately. So you don't have to minimize it and then again open it. So no, that will open all the links or the all the subtopics which you have created in your presentation. So in a nutshell, if you take the printout of it, immediately all the links would be visible. And gradually, if you come back, you press 3, then see, okay, if you press 2, then gradually it would be minimized. Yeah, and so see, if you press this upper left corner, then it says you can edit this map, and for editing you have to be the author of this mind map. Then you can get the embed code. Suppose you like this presentation very much and you want to share this presentation on your website or the blog, so you can get the embed code. Once you press this, then it says it has been copied onto your clipboard, and you go to your website or the blog, there you can paste that embedded code, and this presentation as such would be available on your blog. This feature was explained in the earlier tutorial, and you can take a printout of this presentation so that all the links linked to the main idea, they are immediately made clear. So friends, this was the second tutorial with some more features of Mindomo. Have a nice time. Thanks for watching.